Miami 44 and Virginia 28, Mark Rogers TV with instant analysis. Both teams impressive for different reasons. The Cavaliers came out and they played extremely hard. Ben Kurt on fire. Hit 12 consecutive passes to start the game. His first incompletion was a throwaway. 195 yards passing on his first 12 completions as Virginia came out steaming. They completed a 3rd and 7. Ben Kurt was 5 for 5 on the first drive, 70 yards. It was Olamide Zaccheaus with the brilliant catch and run as he juked guys, broke several tackles in the Miami secondary to go up at 7-0. Zaccheaus had 6 catches for 67 yards. Ben Kurt finished 28 of 37 for 384, 4 touchdowns, and they won a crucial, crucial pick. All right. Miami on third down this season, and I've yet to check the numbers today, but awful from all sorts of distances. So they broke it down on the game broadcast. Miami's third down efficiency offensively, 3rd and short, 3rd and mid-range, 3rd and long, all at best 90th in the country. From 90th to 128th in the country in converting third downs for Miami. Quinn Blanding had a brilliant interception off the deflection. Juan Thornhill actually made the tremendous play on the pass breakup as he crossed the receiver's grill. He broke up the pass, and Blanding made the interception. We talked about Quinn Blanding this week as one of the better defenders in college football over the last few years. Should be a number one pick in the NFL draft. So Virginia was set up, already up 7-0 near midfield. They completed some third downs. Zaccheaus made a catch on a third down to convert the first down, except McLeod forced the fumble, so Miami got it back. Braxton Berrios missed on a wide open play in which he cut through the seam, and on the post pattern, Rozier missed him, and Virginia took over on that play. Joe Reed got behind the defense. Miami missed the coverage. Blew the coverage. Joe Reed going 75 yards behind the defense, and it was 14-0 Virginia. Then they got a little fancy, and maybe if it works, you say, hey, they took advantage of the momentum of the scenario of Miami being down 14-0, onside kick, and Virginia basically pulled it off. But they had a block downfield before the ball went 10 yards. You can't do that. The penalty gave Miami great field position inside the 40-yard line. Jeff Thomas made a catch, or did he make a catch? It was only his one catch on the day, and he possibly trapped it against the ground. There was no official review on the play. Miami got up to the line. They ran the next play. The officials never checked it out. Thomas definitely had the ball against the ground. It didn't appear as though it moved. It would have been an interesting call. Probably would have held the call on the field for 33 yards down to the 10. And then Amon Richards catches it for the touchdown. And Miami's finally on the board at 14-7. As I mentioned, Ben Kurt played out of his mind, and he had to. Miami was not allowing any rushing offense on this day. 28 carries, 55 yards for the Virginia ground game. So Virginia on this next series defensively stuffed the slip screen to Amon Richards on the left side. It was a 3rd and 2. It looked to be open. Micah Kaiser came over, made a tremendous play. They snuffed it out. Virginia was rolling at 14-7. However, they made one of the few crucial mistakes that they made on this day that really cost them the game. They outplayed Miami for about 3 quarters in this game, but they made the crucial play that we just noted on the onside kick. Then they had a muffed punt here that was recovered by Travis Homer. So he picked up the turnover chain, and Miami was all set at the 35-yard line. And then it was Rozier on the touchdown pass, and it was 14-all at that point. So if I can read my notes here, Ben Kurt continued to hit the passes downfield. The one misstep by Bronco Mendenhall and his offensive coordinator, I thought, was 14-all game. It's late in the first half, and Virginia's driving. Ben Kurt is lighting it up. They cannot penetrate the Miami rush defense, and they've got a 3rd and 2 play, and they took it out of Ben Kurt's hands, and it got blown up in the backfield, and they turn it over right there. Interesting note during this game, Micah Kizer leading the ACC in total tackles for a third consecutive season, the first player to do that since Luke Kuechly, now starting with and starring with the Carolina Panthers in the ACC. Tremendous player, of course, at Boston College. Ben Kurt, before the half, makes the beautiful throw to Andre Levron. That play had to be reviewed, but Ben Kurt rolled to his left away from pressure, threw it up for 45 yards in the touchdown to make it 21-14 at that point. He was tremendous on the day, and this was when he was in the pocket. This was on designed rollouts. This was scrambling away from pressure. Ben Kurt making the plays. He threw an over-the-shoulder when he was flush from the pocket to Daniel Hamm. Hamm's only catch of the day as he got behind the defense, and he wasn't even open when Ben Kurt threw him open to the pylon, and it was 28-14 at that point. Rozier made a big third-down throw, got the ball to Cager on the touchdown to make it 28-21. Then the play of the day, because Virginia, despite giving up the last touchdown and only up seven at 28-21, had the ball back, up seven in its possession. And the game that the play that seemed to turn the tide going Miami's way was Jaquan Johnson making a tremendous play. So when they shot it from the end zone angle, he was in the middle of the field and he broke on the ball. He knew where Ben Kurt was going. Ben Kurt shouldn't have double clutched, and Johnson broke on the ball, picked it off, went 30 yards for the touchdown on the pick six, and tied it at 28. The place was rocking. Virginia could never recover from there. They did stay in the game. They drove it down the field. There should have been a pass interference on a key fourth down play. So Virginia gets to no man's land at about the 35-yard line, decided to go for it on fourth and six. Ben Kurt goes up top, and there should have been a pass interference called on Miami on that play. Not called. Miami takes over. It's still a tie game at that point. Miami drives down the field, and another missed opportunity for Virginia here as Bryce Hall stepped in front for what have most likely been a pick six at midfield. He dropped it. Next play, Virginia does get the interception, but the interception, instead of probably coming back the other way for the touchdown, is down near the 10-yard line. And then R.J. McIntosh really put his foot down, got into the backfield again. So McIntosh was the player who blew up the third and two we talked about when Ben Kurd should have been throwing. He blows up this play. And we talk about Micah Kizer leading the ACC in total tackles. Well, McIntosh should be the ACC Defensive Player of the Year and considered for national honors. He has been a monster the entire season, blows up the third and one play, and Miami takes over again. So right now we've got a 28 all game, and there's about after the Badgley field goal set up by the McIntosh stop, Virginia short kick, only a 30-yard kick when they needed their punter to really blast one out of the end zone. They only get it out to the 35-yard line, and that set up the Michael Badgley, what turned out to be the game decider, to make it 31-28. Virginia's defense did a fine job of holding Miami out of the red zone there. So there's 8.5 minutes left. It's 31-28. Virginia drives again down the field, but on a fourth and three, Jordan Ellis at running back whiffed on a block up the middle in which Trent Harris came up and just knocked him aside, gives up the sack there. And then Miami takes back over. They score the touchdown with Travis Homer, and actually, Homer got him close, of course, getting down to the one-yard line, and that's where it looked like the game was over. 31-28, looked like Homer scored. The refs called him out at the four-yard line. Virginia made a couple of nice plays to drive Miami back to close to the 20-yard line. It looked like Miami would have to opt for the field goal to only go up at six. Virginia gets the ball back. They're only down six, 4 minutes left to play. But a well-designed quarterback draw and well-executed and blocked more than anything. Rozier takes it in up the middle and extended the lead to 37-28. And by all intents and purposes, the game was over there. But Virginia, of course, with about 4 minutes left, could have had two possessions. But on a 4th-and-5 play. LeBron drops the ball on the right side. Another Ben Kurt delivery right on the money, right between the numbers. He dropped it and the game was over. Homer tacks on the late meaningless touchdown to make it 44-28, and Miami escapes. There were about 5 Virginia mistakes that cost them the game here, but Miami outplayed them in the fourth quarter, and that was decidedly the game. Virginia couldn't get any ground game going in support of Ben Kurt. There was just too much on his shoulders as he was playing out of his mind for most of the game. And late in the game, Miami made the plays to win. Travis Homer, 6 carries, 5 yards in the first half. Then he exploded for the 11 carries and 91 yards in the second half as the Canes go to 10-0. They've got a date Friday at Heinz Field at Pittsburgh. This could be considered another trap game. They survived this one. Survived earlier ones against North Carolina, most notably an ugly 24-19 win against one of the worst teams in the country. And they win this one over a decent Virginia team. Virginia really showed us something in this game. They've been up and down this season, but certainly much improved over 2-10 in Bronco Mendenhall's second season. The Cavaliers have to get off the deck quickly, get ready for Virginia Tech, their rivalry game on Friday. Mark Rogers TV with instant analysis of Miami surviving Virginia 44-28. It was much closer than the final score would indicate, but the Canes do survive, the number 3 team in the nation. And would love to hear your comments on Miami and Virginia right here on Mark Rogers TV.